Hello everyone, myself Manjula. Now I am going to talk about this complex analysis, probability and statistical methods. In that, now I am going to derive the derivation of the complex integral formula. Cauchy's integral theorem. First, we should know the statement of the Cauchy's integral theorem. The statement will be like this. If f of z is analytic inside and on a simple closure curve C and A is any point within the given region C, then we can write this Cauchy's integral formula in this way. F of A equals to 1 by 2 pi I integration over C f of z divided by z minus a with respect to z. Here the complex function f of z is analytic. Already they given it as analytic function. So this analytic function is valid only on and inside the given contour C. Then only we can use this Cauchy's integral formula. So now we have to do the proof of this. The proof. Before going to do the proof, first we have to consider some of the datas. So clearly they given in a statement A is any point within the given region C. Now the same point we will put in the circle. We can take that circle as C1. So we can take the given point as a center of the circle C1, and also radius will be R. And thus the circle C1, the entire the circle C1, it should be lies within the given contour C. Then the function f of z divided by z minus a is analytic inside and on the boundary of the annular region between C and C1. The same thing now I am going to show in the diagram. Here x axis and then y axis is there. In the first region, actually the some contour is there. Within that contour, the circle I taken as a C1 with the center A and the radius R. What I explained in the previous slide, the same thing I depicted in the form of diagram. So now we have to prove this Cauchy's integral formula. We have to prove this Cauchy's integral formula. Now I am going to take the help of consequences of Cauchy's theorem. This consequences of Cauchy's theorem, already it is explained in the Cauchy's theorem. The statement will be like this. Integration over C f of z divided by z minus a with respect to z, which is equals to the integration over C1 f of z divided by z minus a with respect to z. We can take that as equation number 1. Clearly I explained that C1 implies it is a equation of the circle. The circle equation will be like this. Modulus of z minus a, which is equals to r. Here a represents the center of the circle and r represents the radius of the circle. Now we can simplify this. Z minus a can be written as r into e to the power I theta. So now if I want z means, so z equals to a plus r into e to the power I theta. Clearly I mentioned that C1 represents the circle equation. In a circle equation, theta varies from 0 to 2 pi. It means 0 to 360 degree. If I differentiate this z means, that will become dz, which is equals to ir e to the power I theta with respect to theta. So this data we have to substitute in the equation number 1. So that becomes integration over C f of z divided by z minus a with respect to z, which is equals to integration. Theta is varying from 0 to 2 pi. F of z, in place of z, we have to substitute the value as a plus r e to the power I theta divided by z minus a means r into e to the power I theta, and the differentiated value of z dz also we have to substitute. Here two terms r and e to the power I theta will get cancelled, and I is a constant term, we can take that I outside, and rest of the term we can write as it is. Here r as the radius of the circle, it is very small, we can consider that as a 0, r is tending to 0. So if we consider r is tending to 0, then we can write the previous equation as integration over c f of z divided by z minus a with respect to z can be written as I is a constant term, we can take outside, and f of a plus r into e to the power I theta, it becomes just f of a since r is 0 here with respect to theta. Now f of a is a constant term, we can take outside, integration 1 with respect to theta, nothing means here 1 will be there. So integration with respect to theta means we will get theta. Theta is varying from 0 to 2 pi. So we have to substitute upper limit and lower limit for the term theta. Then we will get f of a into 2 pi I. Thus solution we can represent in this form. F of a can be written as 1 by 2 pi I integration over c f of z divided by z minus a with respect to z. This is what our required Cauchy's integral formula. Now, with the help of this Cauchy's integral formula, we can also derive generalized Cauchy's integral formula. First, we have to define the statement. If f of z is analytic inside and on a simple closed curve C, and if a is a point within C, then we can write this generalized Cauchy's integral formula in this way. Fn of a can be written as n factorial by 2 pi I integration over c f of z divided by z minus a to the power n plus 1 with respect to z. Now we have to do the proof of this. We have to prove this generalized Cauchy's integral formula with the help of Cauchy's integral formula. Just now only we proved, now with the help of that we have to do. So first we have to write the equation for this, the formula for this Cauchy's integral formula. F of a can be written as 1 by 2 pi I integration over c f of z divided by z minus a with respect to z. Here directly we can't, integration is with respect to z is there, directly we can't do the integration. We can go for using this Leibniz rule. Now I am going to apply the Leibniz rule for differentiation under the integral sign. So according to this Leibniz rule, integration is with respect to z. It means z is the variable. Leibniz rule, if I want to apply, means here a is the constant term. So I have to do the differentiation is with respect to the constant. So f dash of a, the Cauchy's integral formula, we have to do the differentiation is with respect to z we have to do. So f dash of a, which is equals to 1 by 2 pi I integration over c f of z dou by dou a 1 by z minus a with respect to z. Here outside the integral sign, the differentiation is ordinary differentiation. But if I taken the differentiation inside the integral sign, means that ordinary differentiation will become a partial differentiation. Because of that only I used here dou. So it means a is the variable, z is the constant inside the integral sign while doing the differentiation. So f dash of a can be written as 1 by 2 pi I integration over c f of z. So now we have to do the differentiation with the help of x to the power n formula. So that can be written as f dash of a can be written as 1 factorial by 2 pi I integration over c f of z divided by z minus a whole square with respect to z. Now same thing we can do for the one more time differentiation. Applying same Leibniz rule, 1 second for this f dash of a. Easily we can write even this f double dash of a also. So 1 factorial by 2 pi I is a constant term. If I taken that differentiation inside the integral sign, means that will become a partial differentiation is with respect to a. We have to do the differentiation. After the simplification, we will get f double dash of a, which is equals to 2 factorial by 2 pi I integration over c f of z divided by z minus a whole cube with respect to z. Same thing we can do up to nth derivative. After differentiating n times, we obtain fn of a has n factorial by 2 pi I integration over c f of z divided by z minus a to the power n plus 1 with respect to z. Here fn of a represents the nth derivative of f of z at the point z is equals to a. This is what our required generalized Cauchy's integral formula. Thank you.